Hello, Dominic from BMT Spain, and today I'm going to answer a question of one of my subscribers named Chris. He asked me, do you have exercises to surf with the pancake grip or the Eastern forehand grip? Well, Chris, I do not have special exercises. For the flat surf, you can throw a few balls, but that's it. It's better to do it with the racket and get used to that whipping action, but you can start throwing a few balls. The difference is, if you make with that continental grip and you make all these motions, yeah, your racket will be in this position. Now if my racket will be the ball, my ball will be pointing to the left side, and in that throwing motion I start to have that pronation, which you won't have in that pancake grip. In that pancake grip, your racket will be open, coming more from behind, having more that flexion and extension, so the ball is more forward. So you can throw a few balls like this to have the idea of that whipping action you make here, but that's it. It's better to do it with the racket, so you stay here and you hear that noise, woo, that whip. That's where you get that racket head speed in the pancake grip surf. Yeah, in the other surf with the continental grip, you have more that pronation where you have that acceleration. So the difference will be also, and which has more advantages, you don't have to worry about positioning here, about how much hip rotation, how much shoulder rotation, how much shoulder over shoulder, all this, how much dropping behind the back. You don't have to think about that. You just take here your position, like you are going to throw the ball to the other side. Your racket will stay all the time on the right side, and it's like throwing, but you have more that whipping action. So this is what you have to focus. Just take your position, don't worry about bending the knees too much. Just go like you whip the racket against that ball like this. I think this is a decent speed, so don't think too much. Just whip the racket, don't hold back, don't squeeze too hard. Make that whipping action, that forehand grip. Here you see on three, you go here, it even sticks in the fence. Now, the slicer. Most important part that you have to understand is the angle of your racket the moment you make contact. So, the moment you stay here also on the right side, you whip that racket, but the racket should be in this angle. The moment you touch the ball, the racket should be pointing to the corner of the service box. And this is the most difficult part. This is where you have more variation, too much or too little, in that slicer. But you try to find the angle. Well, this one was not so bad. So as you can see, you can also have that slice. Just try to find the angle of the racket the moment you make contact. Now the kick surf or the topspin surf. For the topspin surf, that grip is very good to start, because the moment you stretch, the racket is already open. So if the racket is open and you just push upside, now you can see the ball will already have topspin. So take that sideways position and just learn to stretch. As you can see, you already have good spin. You already have good spin. Now, for most people, this will not be fast enough. Now you have to make that table. If you throw your racket, you just stretch and you let the racket go, it's like a table. Even with that continental grip, you stretch, let go, you have a table. Now you go to that pancake grip, you do the same, you stretch, you have a table. Now you do the same against the ball, you stretch and making that table, and now the ball will have more speed. There you go. Still have that spin with more speed. So stretch, making the table if you want more speed. If you need more speed, you need to throw the ball more into the court. So not above your head behind you, but behind you and more on the left side of your head. So you are here throwing the ball more in the court. So that's a good topspin. I have control, go here. Voila, making that stretch and table motion. So, recap, flat surf, whip action, slice serve, the angle you have to make, kick serve, topspin serve, yeah, is the table. Now, I just said kick, you can do kick. Kick is that the ball bounces more to the right side, but for that, you have to make that full pronation. So here, you go up and you make that table. Now, for the more kick, you have to go up and make a full rotation. So let me try two balls. So here you have the same. And that ball goes well to the right side. So more pronation for that kick serve. So, Chris, I hope this was a little more clear. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.